Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to create a React app and add the Syncfusion Context Menu component to it. The React Context Menu is a graphical user interface component that appears when the user right-clicks or performs a touch and hold action. In this video, you will learn how to configure the Context Menu component with the built-in features, item binding, icons, multilevel nesting, navigation links, animation, and customization. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the command npx create React app. I provide the app name, my React app. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the context menu component, I type the npm install at syncfusion slash ej2 react navigations hyphen hyphen save command. Now, the package will be installed. Before using a Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. For instructions on how to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Since the 2022 Volume 1 release, the Syncfusion React license key registration is mandatory. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. I import the context menu component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Navigations package. Here, I am going to display the context menu inside a division element, so I add that division tag with an ID attribute and include the context menu component tag. Then, I define the target property inside the component and assign the division element ID to show the context menu options on this specific target element. The context menu will not be displayed on the browser right now, as there are no menu items in it. To visualize the context menu on a target element in the browser page, I need to add appropriate menu items to it. I want to display three options. So, I define an array named menu items and assign an array of objects with the text property. I set the string values to the text property to display in the menu items. Now, I assign this array to the components items property. After that, I need to add the CSS reference for context menu component. So, I open the app.css file and remove the default styles. Then, I import the material theme CSS reference. I add dependent CSS references like buttons, lists, inputs, and pop-ups. To align the component, I define CSS styles including border, height, padding, text align, and width. Now, let me save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. When I right-click on the target element, the context menu displays. Next, I will show you how to add icons to the context menu items to provide visual representation of an action. First, I include the icon CSS property in this item and set the class name to eIconsEcut. These predefined classes would apply icon to the respective menu item within the context menu. Then, I open the app.css file and assign the appropriate content value to access the cut icon. As you can see, the context menu now displays the cut icon. Next, I will show you how to set multilevel nesting in the context menu. we can add any number of child items to each item in the context menu. Here, I am planning to add sub-options in the paste menu. So let me include items property inside the paste item. And then add the merge formatting and keep source formatting child items. See, when I hover over the paste item in the context menu, its child items are displayed. Next, to navigate to another web page when an action item is clicked, I add the new item navigate. And set the Syncfusion documentation link to the URL property. See now, when I click the navigate item, the current page navigates to the documentation page. To change the animation of the context menu, you can use the animation settings property. By default, the context menu shows the slide down effect. The supported effects for context menu are slide down, zoom in, fade in, and none. I add the animation settings property and assign the value animation. Then, I define an object called animation. Inside this function, I set the duration to 800. By default, the duration is 400. And the effect to fade in. Now, when I click the context menu, it shows the fade in effect. Finally, I will show you how to customize the list items using the before item render event. I add the before item render event and assign the event handler render. Then I define the method render. In this method, I add the class custom to each list item. To use the menu event args, I need to import it from Syncfusion EJ2 React Navigations package. Within the app CSS file, I define the custom class with the styles float, font style, and font size. And now, the list items are customized in the context menu. In this video, I have shown you how to add the context menu component to a React application. I also showed you a few of its basic features. If you would like to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.